हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडेज पोस्ट टॉपिक इज ऑन एक्यूपंचर एंड एक्यूप्रेशर। नाउ एवरीवन आर वेल अवेयर व्हाट इज मीन बाय एक्यूप्रेशर एंड एक्यूपंचर, बट टुडे इन टुडेज टॉपिक वी विल लर्न हाउ द प्रोसीजर इज डन एंड व्हाट इज द पर्पज ऑफ एक्यूपंचर एंड एक्यूप्रेशर। Introduction. Some specific sites on the skin are possessing a decreased electrical skin resistance and increased electrical conductivity. These points are connected by meridian, channels of bioenergy or bioelectricity, through which blood and energy flow. Superficial master points consisting of 12 main channels, 8 secondary channels and a network of sub-channels connects areas of the skin to deeper channels and allow systematic regulation of many body functions. These master points are especially effective in alleviating pain along the entire meridian. Acu means needle or pointed object, and puncture or pressure means sticking. I hope how the acupuncture and acupressure system works. In our body, we everyone know that is a electricity conductivity in our body channels. Now these channels are divided into main 12 channels and 8 secondary channels, okay. Now using these channels, because these channels is the systematic regulation, means in which the body blood through our body flow, okay. We are you going mean acupuncture and in acupressure, these channels are used to minimize the pain, soreness, or the it also called as the trigger points. Trigger points are where the problem has occurred, and if we use a accurate pressure or acupuncture on it, then the effect of the injury will be minimized, and such repeated sessions if you do, the injuries will be vanished. Meaning of acupuncture. In acupuncture, the points are stimulated with needles. The needle penetrates deeply into the tissue. Okay, students, here it is the procedure of the acupuncture. Like we all know what is mean by puncture. Okay, like how if anything a pointed pokes in our bike tire or in a cycle tire, how it punches. In same manner, we are going to use needles to penetrate, and through needles, the needles will be hollow. Through needles, a medicine will be put inside the body, means where the pain is there. Where the pain is there, those points are also called as triggered points. Okay, where the stimulation is necessary, where the medication is necessary. Through these pointed objects or needles, we can use medicine to transfer in our body. Okay, for this purpose, it is called as acupuncture. Now, next one is acupressure. In acupressure, the points are stimulated by pressing with fingers or thumb. Pressure can also be given on the points by a pointer or a specific device called jimmy. The pressure is applied using the thumb or fingertip, moving from point to point along the part of the channel being treated. Now students, as I said, acupressure means where the pressure is needed and the pressure is put by finger or using the thumb. Okay, now few people's are afraid of using or poking the needle into their body. Okay, for them what is the alternate method? So this is the acupressure method will be utilized on them. As we are studying this chapter for sports related, and of course we are going to use this acupressure and acupuncture methods to treat the sports injuries. Now we'll see how this acupressure and acupuncture can treat our sports injuries. The treatment of soft tissue injuries with acupuncture or acupressure differs from the use of acupuncture or acupressure for other problems in a fundamental way. In using acupuncture or acupressure for the treatment of soft tissue problems, the primary points for treatment are the centers of soreness or trigger points. Traditional channel points are used as secondary support points in this type of treatment. The next point is, the major form of modern acupuncture is still the use of filiform needles, often disposable for convenience, sometimes with the addition of electrical needles stimulations via a type of low frequency tense machine made for the specific purpose. Now students, here the needles which are used, the name for those needles are filiform needles. Okay, they once and it is necessary, once they are used it must be disposable. It shouldn't be used on some other person. Just in case if you are doing this course or doing such sessions, just remember this. Whenever the sessions are conducted, new needles will be penetrated in your body. Just remember this, and those needles are called as filiform needles. And now in advanced treatment, like the injury is very serious, in such treatment few electrical stimulations machines are also used, like low frequency. They will just give you a mild electric shock will be circulated in your body to minimize the pain. Such machines are called as tense machines. Okay, those machines are used for with the acupuncture for the extra advantage to relieve the pain as early as possible. The next point is, laser acupuncture is also used, especially for children or patient opposed to the use of needles but suffers from the needle to treat one point at a time and is less potent except on the more superficial point. Low powered soft lasers are used. Now students, this is also advanced technique. Now children and old people or the patients, as I said, who are scared to of needles to penetrate in their body, they are scared for it. So for them, what is the alternate method is the laser treatment. Nowadays everyone are aware how the laser treatment are used in many medical procedures, and even in massage or in acupressure or in acupuncture, these treatments are used nowadays. Okay, now in children's also, children's definitely are scared of needles. For them we can use laser treatment. Okay, but one thing, whenever these treatments are used, the trigger points, if you have many injuries, like you have many like soreness points in your body, in this laser treatment, those points are treated individually. Means they can, like in acupuncture or in acupressure, how the multiple trigger targets can be used, but in such manner laser cannot be used. The laser treatment will be specific at one time for a one trigger point. Okay, the next point is other forms of pointed stimulation such as TENS and other electronic stimulators or acupressure are also viable means of treatment in the absence of or in addition to the use of needles. As I explained you earlier, there are many electronic stimulators like TENS and acupressure also used for such treatment in addition with the needles. Students, I hope you like this topic, and the message of conveying the what is meant by acupuncture and acupressure is loud and clear to you all. Thank you. Stay fit and healthy.